So it's been half the year we have spent staying at home, teaching and learning online. Okay. So have you ever imagined we would come across one such situation in our life? I don't think, not even in our wildest dreams, did we imagine such a thing. Okay. So that's how it is. We have to move on in this way only. Fight out all our network issues and other problems. Okay, so let's start with today's class then. So students, first of all, a quick feedback I would like to take from you. Okay, one thing, I will release your scores today. Okay, I'm very sorry that I wasn't able to release the scores. So I will release the scores today. And one thing which I really observed, and I want to appreciate you all, that I found your performances a lot better than before. Lot better than before. Okay, so that's very good. Someone has switched the mic on. Please switch it off. Just a second. Sorry, I just got an urgent call, so I had to pick it up. Right. So, yes, what was I saying? As we are doing this XML, are you people able to understand XML? Because this is something very new, and you haven't done XML in your any of the previous classes. HTML, of course, you have been learning from class 8, but XML you have not been familiar with, but no doubt it is very easy, okay, because everything is defined by you. You will decide how the data structure would be. You will decide the structure of the documents. So everything depends on you, okay. So how do you find? I want a just honest feedback from anyone. You can just raise your hands if you want to share your ideas. Just raise your hands. Anyone? How do you find XML? Yes, Kushagra? Maybe you can give some honest feedback.
And according to me, it's less interesting than HTML.
HTML. Yes, of course, it's less interesting because it's like that ugly back office assistant who sits at the back office, and just because he's ugly,
Old fashioned.
he's never made to sit on the front desk. Okay, you might have always seen that front desk contains all the beautiful looking ladies dressed in formal attire, and they have wonderful speaking skills, convincing skills, okay, handling problems, and just they smile, and half of the problems are solved. So that's the very reason why they are kept at the front desk, because it's all about visuals, okay, it's all about seeing something. But when it comes to handling some monotonous tasks or difficult tasks where looks don't matter, that always goes into the background. Like you might have seen a movie, okay. What do you see on the screen? You see all the actors who are well-dressed, who are well-built, they have a wonderful personality, okay. And these days I can hardly say that because all their realities are being highlighted. So I can't say that right now, but I'm just talking about any actor in general. So everything looks good. The visuals look good. The locations are wonderful. But the crew which is working behind all this, you may not have very good looking people there. Very simple people, which come from very simple households, they are handling all the tasks in the back end. Or unke bina kuch kaam hoga bhi nahi. Okay, because all that task has to be handled by them. When they work hard, only then we get a nice movie to watch, right? So all those things which are in the back end, those things are usually boring. Those things are not very interesting. HTML is just like that beautiful receptionist, which works mainly on the display of your web page. Okay. So it works on the front end. I had already explained this, and XML works in the back end. Okay. That is, its task is only to store data. उसको कुछ नहीं करना रहता है, बस उसमें आप डेटा स्टोर कर दीजिए और आप उसको एक जगह से दूसरी जगह लेके जाइए. दैट्स इट, दैट्स द ओनली टास्क. मालगाड़ी का काम करता है वो, ठीक है. सो दैट्स द ओनली टास्क विच XML डज, राइट. रेस्ट एक्सट्रैक्टिंग डेटा फ्रॉम दिस, यू नीड अनदर क्रेन और सम अदर थिंग टू पिक अप द गुड्स from the goods train. Okay, so similarly here also you will be needing an external web application or an external web page for picking out the data from the XML document. It's like that. Okay. Anyone else, anything else? Are you able to understand, students? Are you able to understand how to code XML? Okay, that part is okay. And moreover, you have only one chapter of XML, which is just understanding how data is stored. आपको ये भी नहीं जानना है कि उसको कैसे निकालते, but how data is extracted, that would be even more interesting. Okay, because there you will get to work in the front end. But because we are just stepping into it, so we are just going into. Okay, so we were doing this. We were stuck here. Did I share my screen? I don't think. Okay, I didn't share my screen. Fine. So this was what we were doing in the last class, if you remember, supermarket. We have seen this. We have an XML header. We started with the supermarket route. Supermarket is the route over here, right? Which is the very first tab which you open in your XML document. Then you have the product element, which contains many sub elements. The product, which contains many children, that is prod ID, product ID, product name, price, brand. Okay. And so one first product is whole wheat flour. Second product is olive oil. Let us view this on the browser. So I'm just going to go to this folder, XML codes. And you can see I have changed its extension back. So I'm just going to show it once again to you. We'll right click, go to properties. Let me open my glass break application so that I could zoom in over here. You can see over here type of file opens with. I can change this. Right now it is Office XML handler. If I want, I can select any of the available browsers on my computer. So I can select Microsoft Edge. I can select this. I can go to more apps, and I can also select my Opera GX browser. Okay. But in these, both these, why I changed it back to Office XML handler was in both these other browsers, text appears in very small letters, which is barely visible. So I'm just going to show it to you now. It would be visible in a proper way. I hope everybody can read everything here. Can you see it? I think it has a better visibility than the previous ones. Okay. And you can see there is a plus, there's a minus sign over here. That means this product item is already expanded. If you click again on this minus sign, it will turn into a plus sign. That is, it will collapse. Once it is collapsed, this sign changes into a plus sign. It says that if you click on this, you can expand it. So you can just see how you can count how many products are there, two products. You can even squeeze this. When you click on plus, you will be able to expand it nicely. So you can see product ID. So every tag has been formatted. It has been highlighted, syntax highlighted in a different way. And the data appears in big bold letters, right? So it is this data which is extracted by external web applications, right? Okay, today let's move on to some other such exercises. We have already seen this, right? I think some, okay, today also, I think 10th A, B, and C, are they here or only some students? Few students are there. Okay, fine. No problem. Take a look at the code over here. I'm giving you another code. Let's not take this one because already my students have done that. So we are going to take some other code here. Let's see. Wait a sec. Yes, I have this one, vehicle. Take a good look. It's taken from your textbook, students. So I have this vehicle over here. Now, wait, let me change. So this vehicle is your route. This vehicle is your route. This is the route. Okay. Within this vehicle, you have two different types of elements. One is two-wheeler and one is four-wheeler. Within two-wheeler, you have again a bike element, a scooter element. Then within four-wheeler, you have a car element, MUV element. And this Yamaha FZ is a content because you can have multiple different brands of bikes, Yamaha, Pulsar, okay, and so on. And then this is also a content. So this last line is a content. Understood? So what you have to do is you have to create an XML document for this. So look very carefully, students. I'm going to do it over here. So I'm going to divide my page into two equal halves. And I'm going to open a new file here. This is my new file. First, I will save it. Usually I save, you can see very well over here that I save all my XML codes in this folder, class 10 XML codes. I save everything over here. Okay, so I'm going to type the name here. What name should I give to this? Can anyone tell me? What name should I give to this file? You'll get vehicle. The answer on the screen. Yes, you can write it as vehicle or vehicles, whichever. I'm using vehicle. Yes. Dot XML. I have to make sure that the extension is dot XML. Click on save. And now I will start writing the code. So very first line is XML version 1.0. Which version we are using? Encoding technique is UTF, Unicode Text Format, version 8, and close with a question mark and an angular bracket. This header is very important because it identifies your document as being an XML document. Okay, what should I take as the root? Root kya lena chahiye mujhe yahan pe?
Vehicle.
Very good. We have vehicle. To take the root as vehicle, and because I have, you can just note it. I'll remind you once again, XML is case sensitive. So if you are writing vehicle all in small letters, you have to write the closing tag also in small letters only. Next, we start with two-wheeler. Now you can see there are two words, two-wheeler. So aap aisa nahi likh sakte. You cannot write it this way. If you have to differentiate, a tag will consist of only one word. So you can join the two words using an underscore character. Okay, you cannot write it this way. Aap aise nahi likh sakte. Aap isko aise nahi likh sakte with a hyphen in between. This is also wrong. This is wrong. This is wrong. You cannot write, put a dot in between. That is also wrong. You cannot, in fact, put any punctuation mark in between. Okay. All you can do is, the correct form is, either you use an underscore over here. This is not a hyphen. You can see this is an underscore. Okay. Or you use camel case, where you can see that the first word is in lowercase, complete lowercase. Second word is in title case, where the first letter of the second word is capital. So this just resembles the hump of a camel, right? Hence, it is known as camel case. This camel case is a convention. It's a tradition which is followed by most developers around the world. Okay. So this is what you can do. Two-wheeler, you can write it this way, right? Or you can also write it simply like this. These three are the three valid ways and these are the three invalid ways. So please make a note of this, okay? No spaces or special characters in between other than underscore. So two wheeler ho gaya, and now when you type, Atom Portable gives you one facility that the moment you type a few letters, it will give you the closing tag automatically. So after two wheeler, within two wheeler, you have bike. And within bike, you have to write the data, that is the content, Yamaha FZ. Remember, content can be in any case, okay, because you cannot control the content, right? And there could be a space in between because you need to use many such data like address, someone's full name, okay, which always contain a space in between. So content can have anything, but your tags will not have any spaces, right? Next is scooter. Scooter, Activa. How do I write? Where should I start four-wheeler now? Look at the code and tell me. Where should I start four-wheeler?
Ma'am, between
after closing of two-wheeler.
Yes, very good. After closing two-wheeler without giving any line, new line. यहाँ पे यू हैव टू बी वेरी स्पेसिफिक, डोंट गिव एन एक्स्ट्रा लाइन, क्योंकि डिस्प्ले की बात हो ही नहीं रही है, ओके? इसीलिए डोंट गिव एनी एक्स्ट्रा लाइन इन बिटवीन. सो आई एम जस्ट टाइपिंग हियर फोर व्हीलर एंड फोर व्हीलर क्लोज. नाउ विद इन दिस व्हाट शुड आई राइट, टेल मी.
कार
टायर.
यस, वेरी गुड, कार. Okay, I did a mistake. Car, and within car, I will write Swift. Second is MUV. You can say I have typed MUV in capital, but for convenience, I'm typing it in small letters because every time for typing capital, I have to press the Shift key. So I have used this XUV 500. And MUV close. Okay, this is complete now. See, what you might have noticed one thing, that I have a habit of writing the closing tag also. The moment I open a tag, I also close it. Why? Because this way I don't have to worry about which tag to close when. So if you make it a habit, students, half of your problems will be solved. Okay, whenever you open a tag, also quickly close it so that you can keep a track of all the tags, how they are being nested. Understood? Now we'll quickly go to our XML codes folder. We will find, where is it? Yes, this is the vehicle and I'm going to open it and this is how it is. So you can see two-wheeler, four-wheeler. When I expand two-wheeler, it has two elements, bike and scooter. When I expand four-wheeler, it has two elements, car and MUV. Okay, very easy. Let's come to the next part. Some syntax rules of XML. Students, this is most important. Please make a note of it, right? First, XML document can be created using simple text editor like Notepad. And here, what are we using? We are using Atom Portable software. Okay, we are using the Atom Portable software. That is also quite convenient. You can work on that. Right, you can easily download it. All those who are not familiar with Atom Portable software, I will just give you a quick tour at downloading this. You can go open your browser. There are too many applications opened on my computer right now, so I think I'll close a few of them because of which my system is also lagging. Whiteboard. Okay, I'm going to close this whiteboard application. Okay, so I'm just going to type over here Atom Portable Download. Okay, just press enter. and you will be taken over here. So I'm going to this Atom Portable. You can go from Portable Freeware. So here we are. Just you have to, I'll give you the link, okay? So here it is, offline zip download. Just click on this. You can just check it out over here, offline zip download, extract and launch atomportable.exe. So what you will get is, on your computer, you will get a folder. I have this folder in the E drive. This is the folder. And I should be having the Atom Portable. Yes, this is the Atom Portable. Let's take a look. This was the actual file, the zip file, compressed zip file, which was downloaded. So all you have to do is right click on it. I have 7-zip installed. If you don't have 7-zip, you can simply go to extract all. I've just clicked on extract all. So you'll get this dialog box, okay? All you do is simply click on extract. It will extract it in the same folder where your zipped file or zipped folder is there. So I did exactly that and I got this folder over here. You can check this out. When I double click it, this is the Atom Portable application which I have to launch every time I want to start Atom Portable, okay? So Atom Portable is a very easy to use software. As you can see it over here, it is very easy to keep track of all our data. We'll go to view, toggle tree view, and all your codes. You can add your folder and you can see all the different files within that folder at a glance. And if you want, you can also hide it. And you have already seen its IntelliSense technology. That is, the moment I type a few letters of a tag, it automatically gives me the entire tag. Okay, so you can use any of the editors for working in XML. Saved with the extension .xml. Please note it down. .xml is the extension which is needed. XML tags are case sensitive. Please make a note of this. They are case sensitive. There is a difference between, if I write two-wheeler like this, and if I write two-wheeler like this. Okay, these two are two different elements because first one is all lowercase, second one is title case. Got it? Next, closing of a tag is must in XML. You have to close a tag compulsorily in XML. In HTML, some tags were empty tags, but in XML, all the tags are closing tags. Tags must be nested properly. That is, if you are opening a tag last, suppose I have an AAA tag, then you within this, I opened a BBB tag, then I opened a CCC tag, okay? Written the content, I have to make sure that I'm first closing CCC tag, then I'm closing the BB BBB tag, then I'm closing the AAA tag. So, aise hona chahiye. And because you have to keep track of the nesting, it is advisable that use indentation. Indentation means you can see that AAA AAA starts from here after leaving some gap. That is, after some indentation, BB, BBB starts. Then after leaving even more gap, CCC starts. Okay, so this indentation helps you to keep track of the structure of your document. There must be a root element. Very important. Root element is very important. The first element of your XML document. Tag attributes must have a quoted value. Some tags also have attributes here, and those attributes are also user defined. I'm coming to attributes a little later, okay? So these are some of the important syntax rules of XML, okay? I want you all to note them down in your copy right now. I will not tell you to write anything else, but this is very important, okay? You have to keep in mind the syntax rules of XML. Otherwise, whenever you run your program, whenever you run your, sorry, open your XML document in the browser, you will see an error message. अब तक HTML में आपने कोई error message नहीं देखा था, but अब आपको वो error message मिलेगा if you are violating any of these syntax rules, okay? Now syntax means, syntax पानी की टंकी नहीं है, okay? Syntax means grammatical rules. The XML is a language, okay? You are working in a language. Every language has its set of rules. Like English has English grammar, which is a set of rules of English language. Okay. I cannot use the words in any way I want. I have to keep in mind the tenses, the participles, the modals. Okay. All the things I have to keep in mind, and then only I can speak in English. Right. So I have. Every language has its set of rules, and all computer languages, they follow these set of rules in the form of syntax rules. Understood? So that is the meaning of syntax. Once you write it completely, just give me a yes so that I can continue.
Yes, ma'am, done.
Okay, very good. Let me get a few more such feedbacks.
Yes, ma'am, done, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, one very important thing. Apart from all our syllabus, while everybody is writing, I hope you all are following the COVID-19 rules. Not yes, the syntax ma'am. Rules. Are you all following the COVID-19 standard procedures? That is keeping social distancing of 2 meters. Okay. Sorry, 2 feet. 2 feet or 2 meters, is it? It should be 2 meters, I think.
Yes, ma'am. 6 feet.
And 6 feet. Okay, yes. Six feet is ideal distance. And washing your hands, sanitizing your hands whenever, and moving whenever you step out of the house. Are you wearing mask or not? Because we teachers have been instructed to keep reminding you people all this. Okay, so that's why I'm doing that. Even I'm following all the rules, right? Sometimes I also get a bit negligent, and I try to correct myself. So I hope you all are keeping well and be safe. Till the vaccine comes. Vaccine aane tak, tika aane tak tikai rakhna. This is a meme, Facebook meme, which is becoming very popular these days. Yeah, na? So that's what it is. And God says that tika aane tak, tum tike rehna. Okay. I hope everybody has... sorry, everybody has written this?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Let's move on. XML elements. XML documents are made up of tags or elements, just like HTML document. XML tags are user defined, contains opening and closing tag. An element which encloses only other elements is called element only type element. That is an element which contains other elements. Here we saw two-wheeler is one such element. Four-wheeler is one such element because it contains other elements also. Four-wheeler contains car and MUV. Two-wheeler contains scooter and cycle, okay, and bike and scooter. So hence it is an element only type element. Element containing both elements and content is known as a mixed element. Empty elements are usually represented in this way, but normally right now, so far, we haven't encountered about them. So we are going to skip this point for the time being. Okay. So these are all the rules which you have already studied. Some naming rules in XML. This is also very important. Element name can contain letters, digits, underscore character. Make a note of this. You can have letters, that is alphabets, small a to z, capital A to z. Digits, you can have 0 to 9. And in case of special symbol, you can only have underscore character. No other special symbol, no dot, no hyphen, no space, no dollar sign, no ampersand, nothing. Only underscore. Can start only with a letter or underscore. It cannot start with a digit. If you write something like this, I am writing here, one second. I'm writing it like this, one my tag. This is wrong. You cannot do that, okay? Instead, you can write here, my tag one. Or you can also write.
Ma'am, can we use Roman?
You can use Roman letters are nothing, but they are alphabets only. If you are writing something like, this is what it is, I and X. So you can use this. To you, it is Roman. Okay. But when XML parser sees this, it identifies it as an alphabet. Understood? So you can use that. Next is tags are user defined. Of course, you will be creating your own tags. Word XML is the only keyword. Blank spaces are not allowed. Element names are case sensitive. These are the naming rules. Students, in your copy, just note down the one second here. First point and second point. Just these two points you note down. Yes.
Ma'am, this word XML is the only keyword. That means, ma'am, we cannot write this directly, means in a tags.
No, you write XML only once. That is when you are starting the XML document. Jab aap ye likhte ho na, XML version equals 1.0 encoding UTF-8. Jab aap ye cheez likhte ho. Hence, this XML is the only keyword which you are using. You don't use it any, you use it only once in your document just to identify that this is an XML document, not any time else. Okay. Please write the first two marked points which I have given there. This is important. You have to make sure that your XML tags, they don't contain any special symbol, they don't contain any hyphen, they don't contain any space. Okay. Only things, and they should only start with a letter or underscore, not with a digit. This is a common rule. Yes.
Ma'am, this XML, ma'am, can we write like this, ma'am? We are making tags and we are describing about the XML only. So, ma'am, our root tag is, can we write root tag as XML?
No, dear. Why? Because XML is a keyword and keywords have a specific defined purpose. Okay. So, if you want to write XML, you can do it in this way. Instead of using in small letters, you can write it in capital. Or you can write it like this. In title case. Uppercase or title case. Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Here, just mute. Please, everybody, mute your microphone, okay? otherwise they cause a lot of disturbance. So I hope you have written these first two points. I'm moving over to the next. XML tag attributes. Now we are going to study about tag attributes. Before that, let me take a quick attendance of everyone. Done. All of you have studied attributes in HTML, right? Can anyone give me any example of attribute in XML tag? Sorry, HTML.
Height and width attribute. And background PG color.
Yes, very good. Height and width attribute of the
height and width attribute.
Font face equals you write Times New Roman. Okay, ye likhte ho size attribute, color attribute. IMG tag, SRC attribute, width attribute, height attribute, okay, body, background, BG color, text attributes. So in HTML, you have a set number of tags. You have predefined tags and you have their predefined attributes. In XML, you have user-defined tags and you have user-defined attributes also, okay. For example, student ID equals S001. Usually ID fields, okay, they are kept as attributes, right? Product category equals electronics. Understood? So these are some examples, okay, of XML tag attributes. So attributes are used to define those values which are associated with the tag. Jo tag ke saath associated hain. Understood? But information assigned as attributes cannot be used or manipulated by the external application. Hence, it is always a good idea that instead of having attribute, you use it as a separate tag. Instead of using student ID as the attribute, you should use it like this, so that it is read by an external web application. Okay. Hence, we can represent them in the form of child elements. This is a child element. You can see it over here. ID is a child element of student. Example, student, class, student. So here I could have written it this way, student, class, equals 10. Aise bhi likh sakte the. If you are gonna, it's not like you can never use attributes. You can use it, okay. If you are not going to use class, but class, I think it's an important thing, right? You should set any attribute of a tag in XML only when it will not be required by the web application, the external web application, which is using this HTML document. Agar aapko lagta hai ki koi aisa information hai jiski zyada zarurat nahi hai, use aap attribute bana sakte. But if you feel that that information is required to be fetched, don't keep it as an attribute, right? Some points to ponder. Naming rules of attributes are same as that of XML tag. It is mandatory to assign some value to attribute. Naming rules are same. That is, again, no spaces in between. You can use only underscore, alphabets, capital or small, and you can use digits, but you cannot start the attribute name with a digit, right? And they are also case sensitive. Attributes cannot be left with unassigned values. You cannot have it like this. Aapne ye likha student ID. Isko aise aap nahi chhod sakte. You have to give value to it. Understood? You have to give some value to it. And value has to be enclosed within double quotes. Understood? Value has to be enclosed within double quotes. Is it clear to everyone? So mandatory to assign some value to the attribute. Attributes cannot be left with unassigned values, right? Values assigned to attributes must be enclosed in single or double quotes. Single quotes are these. These are single quotes. More than one value cannot be assigned to a single attribute. One attribute accept only one value. Attributes are non-expandable. You cannot expand these attributes. Okay, these are some important points which you have to keep in mind regarding attributes. Okay, so I hope this much, it is that the rules are almost the same like your other things. So what you do is you just note down this point. 3 points, these 3 points. 1, 2, 3. Only note down these 3 points for attributes. Write the heading. Attributes in XML. Yes, completed. Completed?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let's move on. Comments in XML. What are comments? Now, comments are usually written for the reference, or we can also say better understanding of certain tags or constructs within document for the developer. Usually what happens is more than one people, they sit together in a team, put their heads together and create a project. Okay. So whenever they are sitting together and developing a website, it is quite possible that one person might have worked on, one or two people might have worked on XML. So if they are using proper comment lines in the XML document regarding this data is used for this purpose, this data has used so and so attribute, this is the information, this is how the structure appears, and all the necessary details. So it becomes easier for the other people to figure out what is going on or what type of data is stored in this XML document, right? Comment lines are those lines which are not read by the XML parser. They have no role in the display or parsing of the XML or reading or comprehending the XML document. They are what they are, they only stay in the document used only for a reference purpose. Okay. So they are non-processable components of the XML document. They are never processed. used to create reference point for different sections of the document. Leave a note about the document structure. They are just like post-it notes, which are posted. You might have seen post-it notes, which normally in Western countries or even if some people in our countries use. Okay. Buy milk. Okay. So this is what, it's a simple post-it note, a small comment which is there. Or suppose lot many things, what you might have also seen that when people, office workers, what they do is their computer in their office cubicle, it is full of post-it notes. They have only put some notes for reference. They are like reminders. Okay, tomorrow I have to make a phone call to so-and-so company. I have at that such so-and-so time, I have to pick up my daughter. So all these things they are just writing in post-it notes and they post it on top of the monitor so that always whenever they come and sit, they are reminded. They are like reminders. Okay. So post-it notes have no other touch option rather than reminding or reference. So comments in XML also do the same thing. They only remind people. They only make people understand what is going on in the document. Almost all programming languages, they use comment lines. Understood? So we stop over here and we will continue in the next class. So I hope this class is clear to everyone.